I consider Arnold not Arnold. I consider him bodybuilding. Arnold is bodybuilding to me, to everyone else. Arnold is what opened the door for us. Before Arnold and Franco, Arnold and Franco were the first real pros of bodybuilding. Before them, there was no such thing as professional bodybuilding. Now there's maybe 20 or 25 professionals able to do what all of us here are doing today throughout the year. But without Arnold's initial influence and initial onset to the scene, it would never be where it is today.
But if we accept the idea that the sport has progressed in the last 5 years...
Well, it certainly has.
Well, how would you rate Arnold's chances if he was in shape the same as he was before and, say, competing tomorrow?
He'd win.
I think that Arnold would have his hands full if he were to compete now, unless he really became really serious about his training and did all that was necessary for him to do to get in tip-top shape. But if Arnold were able to come back and win these contests after a short interval, it means that the sport of bodybuilding has literally stood still for the last 5 years. This, in my opinion, is not true.
Okay, the first contestant is Danny Padilla. Boyer Coe is the second contestant. Roy Duval is the third. The fourth contestant, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Roger Walker is number five. Roger Walker from Australia. Roy Callender, number six. Roy Callender.
I had intended around 8 weeks ago to start training very hard with the objective in mind to get in my best possible shape for a film I'm going to do, which is Conan the Barbarian. And we're going to start shooting the first few scenes in October. And so I really wanted to be muscular because the idea was that Conan was a very muscular, heroic-looking guy and that I should be in top shape. So all along with sword fighting lessons and dancing lessons and all that, I did my bodybuilding. But the closer I came to this competition, the more people started speculating on the idea that I would be competing. And the more I started thinking about the possibility. And so around 3 weeks or 2 weeks ago, I decided, well, I think it would be kind of an interesting challenge, really, to do something in 8 weeks that most of the guys do preparing a year or 2 years in advance.
When I train, it really depends on what body part I train, you know, what I think about. But it always has to be something that has involved in some form or the other with self-hypnosis. You know, I really psych myself up for it. Because otherwise it's impossible to squat with 400 or 500 pounds. I mean, it's really hard to do that, and it can be boring. And so what you do is you create a certain excitement, and that's what you think about. You think about your next set, you think about the particular muscle that you're training. You try to isolate the muscle, you try to pump it up, you let blood go into this area and stuff like that. And your feedback then always is that the muscle is responding, and that means growth. Can you pull out the hand here?
Pull the pin out somebody, kid.
Okay, thank you. Films. Whenever you see a camera around, you always do like this. To make the trauma build up a little bit.
The shoulder's over 100 pounds.
That's right. It is a 10-pound blade, but you must make it sound like it was 1,000 pounds.
So everybody thinks you're
macho.
Thank you.
Septum. Septum. Achtum. Neunzehn, du faules Schwein.
Concentration is one of the things that I've learned from bodybuilding more than anything. Focus in, concentrate on one thing, and not, no matter if there's a bomb exploding around you, you do not lose your concentration. You know, there's also a wonderful thing to be equipped with, you know.
Striving after an ideal, in a sense that you're molding your physique, right? You're developing your body, changing the contours and shapes of the muscles so it looks a certain way you want it to look, a certain mental perception you perceive, trying to gain that or trying to make yourself into that perception. There's a lot of mental training involved in bodybuilding. I think also you're cultivating a feeling inside. You have a need. Calling, much like a priest, have this inert need to do something that you must do, and you'll not be happy unless it's fulfilled. And that's where I'm at. That's why I'm here today. In fact, I believe very much that bodybuilding is more mental than physical. Your concern with this, first of all, this mental projection, of what you want to look like, what you want to be like, as far as the contour and shape of your body. You're concerned with daily feelings of exercises and handles and muscles. You're concerned with putting your mind in the muscle.
Remember also that every man in this competition is already a world champion. To be able to compete in the Mr. Olympia, the first requisite is that you must have won a Mr. Universe title or a world championship. Facing me, please. Face me, please. Chris, this way, please. Tricep pose, please. Turn forward.
I was worried from the time I stepped on a stage for the first round. It's amazing how insecure you get after not being on stage for 5 years. I mean, I used to go out and it was my home on stage. This time I went out and I felt very uncomfortable, you know, being a showpiece out there, you know, being always having people look at you in a bathing suit. I am the kind of a character that doesn't like to expose himself, okay? And whatever you see on stage, that's you, you know? And whenever you watch somebody in a gymnasium, the way he trains, that's an extension of him. And I felt this time I had to expose myself. I had to stand out there for an hour or two and just be compared to all those different guys. And that is what I didn't like at all. The important thing is that you always challenge yourself, you know, and I'm a strong believer in the philosophy of staying hungry, you know, and really always being hungry for more and being hungry for bigger and better things, you know, and whenever I have achieved the goal, then immediately after that, I ask myself, what other challenge can I put up to try to achieve, you know, and that's what staying hungry basically means. I'm a strong believer also in the Western philosophy of conquering, of achieving, of climbing, of getting higher and higher to the top and all those things. Because that's, in my opinion, what life is all about, is living rich rather than just existing and just wasting away your life, since we only have one in our.
I consider bodybuilding philosophical, very much so. I question my existence. Why do I exist? Where am I going? I always had this craving for more. I compare this to Jonathan Livingston Seagull. This Seagull wanted to do something different than the normal everyday thing which he was supposed to do, and they urged him to do. He wanted to expand and to wonder and to do something unique and artistic. And not only in the sense for expanding his artistic ability, but for this, in the sense of his expanding his awareness. To me, it's the same type of thing I associate with my bodybuilding. So naturally, the dedication I have for the sport is very intense. I'll give anything. I'll give total commitment to do it, because I must do it to the best or better than I can possibly do it to my ability. And that's what it's all about tomorrow night on stage. All year long, I've been doing this, and now, final day is here to show what I've done.
We'll be right back.
three-time Mr. Olympia, Frank Zane.
Number one, I will win. And we'll come on strong, stay long, talk loud, and win the Olympia crowd.
Really?
That's it. Say it, believe it, and achieve it. It's as simple as that. Schwarzenegger goes today. Evita Zane, Evita Schwarzenegger. Samir's coming on strong.
All right, right on.
The Lebanese man.
Lebanese lover.
Oh. How you doing, Kenny?
Good.
Hello, Kenny. Here's my manager. He's responsible for
feeling
everything.
Good? Feeling
signs
good?
Signs the checks. Keeps you rolling.
You have the pen. The pen is mightier than a muscle in this particular case, right?
That's the gold pen.
Remember the golden rule. He who has the gold makes the rules.
Zane and Arnold in big trouble today.
Oh, I know that.
That's goddamn close.
Yeah.
Remember that.
Right. Oh, yeah, I will.
You remember that. This damn thing is so close out there. They got so many great bodies in there. You know?
Yeah.
I've never seen so many guys coming in shape in one contest.
That's right, yeah, it's a dangerous situation.
That's right.
Yeah, I picked the right year, didn't I?
Hey, check
it out, like.
Check it out, Tommy. Excellent.
A little bit too light, maybe.
Nah. You look great.
It's never been that ripped.
Well, I just saw something here tonight, just now, right in here, that didn't exist on stage today.
Well, with that fucking lighting out there, nothing exists. I mean, that's another story.
Good. Brutal. Massive. Brutal. That's it.
You look much better than ever, by far.
He looks better than ever.
Ripped.
Which is enough.
Oh, man.
Yeah, how can you look more than better than ever?
That's pretty hard to do. Maybe next year better than ever.
Yeah. See? But this is next year.
Yeah. You've been reading some philosophy, too, I see. I've been doing that every night now, reading philosophy.
Which is good.
It's interesting. It keeps my mind clear.
Fantastic. Confused.
Lost.
What do I do now?
How long do you think it will be till we get up there?
Another hour. About an hour to go.
I mean, for now?
Yeah.
Vielleicht sprichst du von eins, zwei, drei. Oder vierte?
Ja.
Eins? Ja, und dann den anderen mit den neuen Arm vorne.
Sechs?
Ja, das ist besser, glaube ich. Und du?
I would relax if I were you.
Can anybody find out how much more time it is?
We have exactly 20 minutes, okay?
You go out there?
Yeah.
Good. You can actually create a vision of what your body will look like. And then you mold your body closer and closer to that vision. And actually, you will turn this vision into reality. And it's wonderful, really, to see that happening, that you actually can see it in front of you, which I think they call the third eye, you know, where you visualize what you want to be in reality, and then you get closer and closer to that. And that's a known thing now in sports, the inner sports, they call it.
Mr. Colombo, how are you doing, sir?
Good face.
No, it's wrong.
Perfect.
Also, I think just the experience of being much stronger than everybody else, I think that's an unbelievable experience. You feel richer. You feel that sooner or later that you can do anything.
where it is. Yeah,
it's pretty.
Is this yours?
Had a good time.
No.
I'm in the best shape of my life. What can I say? I feel great. You know what I mean?
That's good.
And when you know you put your total being, every bit of inner person into your training and into this day, you feel good no matter what. I feel good in that sense. Placing her on. All I know is I'm the best I can be right now. And that's it.
We'll see you later.
Okay.
Everybody likes to be wanted and needed and appreciated and loved and all those things. Some people only have it in a limited way, you know, by just being loved by their family or by their children or by their brother or whatever, a wife. Some people like more than that. Now, I'm one of them. To me, it's always a great pleasure performing in front of a great audience. It really turns me on. And it's a real enjoyable thing, you know, when you see people enjoying what you do.
Schwarzenegger.
You better believe it, man. It was exactly like it used to be. I mean, I got so turned on. It brought back so many great memories.
It's amazing when you're out of it for 5 years. You have to, like, learn all over again. Every step. And, which is a wonderful experience, of course, because it puts you right back where you belong. Which is definitely not in the sky.
But you put it together, Arnold. You put it together. And in 2 months or 2 weeks, the last week.
2 months altogether.
Yeah.
Oh, I wish that I could do it, to have a time machine and just wind it to the front like an hour and a half. Because then we know much more.
Yeah, I can tell you right now,
right?
I know. There's one class of bodybuilder and then there's your class.
How do you feel this time?
Well, I feel this time? Hungry. Craving some food in general. Looking forward to tomorrow. I feel good about today.
I want an ice cream soda about that big. And a pizza pie. And what do you want, a bottle of wine?
I want a bottle of wine, bread, and cheese. Bottle of wine, bread, and cheese, please, right now.
How did it feel up there?
It felt great. It was... I have heard throughout the whole day today that it's a very close contest. And, you know, I want to make sure when it is that close that the last minute you put everything in that you have. And so that's what I did. I really had my friends, you know, psych me up and told me that to be brutal and to get into it, just like in the old days. And so that's what I tried to do, to get really into it and just...
pose and feel the audience, and if the audience likes one pose, to stay long at that pose. If the audience didn't like another pose, to just get out of it as fast as possible, and all those things. So it was like I came closer and closer to the old days on this last routine. So I felt really good at now, and there's one more round to go, which is the pose off with the six best, which are the six best guys. And I think that's exactly when I hit my 10.
Here are the seven finalists in numerical order. Number two, Boyako, USA. Number four, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Number five, Roger Walker. Number six, Roy Callender, Canada. Number seven, Mike Mensa, USA. Number 11, Frank Zane, USA. Number 12, Chris Dickerson, USA. These are the seven finalists. My good friend here, Frank Burwash, will be giving the judges their final papers. And the judges, please, just put number one against your number one choice. Thank you, Frank.
2 days of eating, you're trained for universe. Can I ask if I'm depressed? Yeah. I'm the best I can be right now.
Most people are too close to what they're doing that they can't see themselves anymore, you know? But I always step back and just laugh at myself because it's really, you can't take it seriously, the whole thing, and I can't. I mean, it's just something that I believe we have to do certain things in order to keep us going and motivated and pick little goals and go after them and stuff like that.
Who will be Mr. Olympia? Chris Dickerson. Frank Zane. Mike Mensa. Roy Callender. Roger Walker. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
You have to be able to step back out of yourself and look at it of what you're doing and laugh about it. Because it's all funny. Being the best built man in the world. Very funny. Jim Beam. It's one of the most remarkable products, not only in the United States, but all over the world. People sometimes use it to get high in a bar, maybe after depressions or bad business deals or whatever. But we bodybuilders obviously use it as a high protein and high amino acid supplement. Now let's see.
How do you use that?
Well, we usually put it in a very sophisticated kind of
a jigger, a special jigger.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Now, it's very important that you take the right measurement here because...
I have never drank in my life.
Wait a minute.
Oh, my God. The skin is coming apart.
This is amazing.
Pump.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, do you want to get a pump
buy something from Jim. Fourth place goes to Boya Cole. Third place goes to Frank Zane. Second place, Chris Dickerson. First prize, Mr. Olympia 1980, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
He has that ability to make you love and like and want to vote for him. Arnold has that quality of convincing you that he gives you a good feeling. And you watch Arnold, you go, wow, he's got it together. He feels good. He's in love with life. I want to be like that, too. Arnold walks on the stage. He just puts his arms up over his head. He flexes. People go crazy. They love him.
Thank you very much. I'm extremely excited about winning the seventh time the Mr. Olympia competition, and I have to be very honest that this was the highest level of competition I've ever faced in any competition in my life, and I was not aware of that. That this was it's going to be. Thank you.
I consider Arnold not Arnold. I consider him bodybuilding. Arnold is bodybuilding to me, to everyone else. Arnold is what opened the door for us. Before Arnold and Franco, Arnold and Franco were the first real pros of bodybuilding. Before them, there was no such thing as professional bodybuilding. Now there's maybe 20 or 25 professionals able to do what all of us here are doing today throughout the year. But without Arnold's initial influence and initial onset to the scene, it would never be where it is today.
But if we accept the idea that the sport has progressed in the last 5 years...
Well, it certainly has.
Well, how would you rate Arnold's chances if he was in shape the same as he was before and, say, competing tomorrow?
He'd win.
I think that Arnold would have his hands full if he were to compete now, unless he really became really serious about his training and did all that was necessary for him to do to get in tip-top shape. But if Arnold were able to come back and win these contests after a short interval, it means that the sport of bodybuilding has literally stood still for the last 5 years. This, in my opinion, is not true.
Okay, the first contestant is Danny Padilla. Boya Ko is the second contestant. Roy Duval is the third. The fourth contestant, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Roger Walker is number five. Roger Walker from Australia. Roy Callender, number six. Roy Callender.
I originally had intended around 8 weeks ago to start training very hard with the objective in mind to get in my best possible shape for a film I'm going to do, which is Conan the Barbarian. And we're going to start shooting the first few scenes in October. And so I really wanted to be muscular because the idea was that Conan was a very muscular, heroic-looking guy and that I should be in top shape. So all along with sword fighting lessons and dancing lessons and all that, I did my bodybuilding. But the closer I came to this competition, the more people started speculating on the idea that I would be competing. And the more I started thinking about the possibility. And so around 3 weeks or 2 weeks ago, I decided, well, I think it would be kind of an interesting challenge, really, to do something in 8 weeks that most of the guys do preparing a year or 2 years in advance. When I train, it really depends on what body part I train, you know, what I think about. But it always has to be something that has involved in some form or the other with self-hypnosis. You know, I really psyched myself up for it. Because otherwise it's impossible to squat with 400 or 500 pounds. I mean, it's really hard to do that, and it can be boring. And so what you do is you create a certain excitement, and that's what you think about. You think about your next set, you think about the particular muscle that you're training. You try to isolate the muscle, you try to pump it up, you let blood go into this area and stuff like that. And your feedback then always is that the muscle is responding, and that means growth. Can you pull out the pen here?
Pull the pen out somebody, kid.
Okay, thank you. Films. Whenever you see a camera around, you always do like this. To make the trauma build up a little bit.
The shoulder's over 100 pounds.
That's right. It is a 10-pound blade, but you must make it sound like it was 1,000 pounds.
So everybody thinks you are
macho. Thank you.
Concentration is one of the things that influences bodybuilding more than anything. Focus in, concentrate on one thing, and not, no matter if there's a bomb exploding around you, you do not lose your concentration. You know, it's also a wonderful thing to be equipped with, you know.
Striving after an ideal, in a sense that you're molding your physique, right? You're developing your body, changing the contours and shapes of the muscles so it looks a certain way you want it to look, a certain mental perception you perceive, trying to gain that or trying to make yourself into that perception. There's a lot of mental training involved in bodybuilding. I think also you're cultivating a feeling inside. You have a need, calling, much like a priest, have this inert need to do something that you must do, and you'll not be happy unless it's fulfilled. And that's where I'm at. That's why I'm here today. In fact, I believe very much that bodybuilding is more mental than physical. Your concern with this, first of all, this mental projection, what you want to look like, what you want to be like, as far as the contour and shape of your body. Your concern with daily feelings of exercises and handles and muscles. You're concerned with putting your mind in the muscle.
Remember also that every man in this competition is already a world champion. To be able to compete in the Mr. Olympia, the first requisite is that you must have won a Mr. Universe title or a world championship. Facing me, please. Face me, please. Chris, this way, please. Tricep pose, please. Turn forward.
I was worried from the time I stepped on a stage for the first round. It's amazing how insecure you get after not being on stage for 5 years. I mean, I used to go out and it was my home on stage. This time I went out and I felt very uncomfortable, you know, being a showpiece out there, you know, being always having people look at you in a bathing suit. I am the kind of a character that doesn't like to expose himself, okay? And whatever you see on stage, that's you, you know? And whenever you watch somebody in a gymnasium, the way he trains, that's an extension of him. And I felt this time I had to expose myself. I had to stand out there for an hour or two and just be compared to all those different guys. And that is what I didn't like at all. The important thing is that you always challenge yourself, you know, and I'm a strong believer in the philosophy of staying hungry, you know, and really always being hungry for more and being hungry for bigger and better things, you know, and whenever I have achieved the goal, then immediately after that, I ask myself, what other challenge can I put up to try to achieve, you know, and that's what staying hungry basically means.
I'm a strong believer also in the Western philosophy of conquering, of achieving, of climbing, of getting higher and higher to the top and all those things. Because that's, in my opinion, what life is all about, is living rich rather than just existing and just wasting away your life, since we only have one in our.
I consider bodybuilding philosophical, very much so. I question my existence. Why do I exist? Where am I going? I always had this craving for more. I compare this to Jonathan Livingston Seagull. This Seagull wanted to do something different than the normal everyday thing which he was supposed to do, and they urged him to do. He wanted to expand and to wonder and to do something unique and artistic. And not only in the sense for expanding his artistic ability, but for this, in the sense of expanding his awareness. To me, it's the same type of thing I associate with my bodybuilding. So naturally, the dedication I have for the sport is very intense. I'll give anything. I'll give total commitment to do it, because I must do it to the best or better than I can possibly do it to my ability. And that's what it's all about tomorrow night on stage. All year long, I've been doing this, and now, final day is here to show what I've done. We'll be right back.
time Mr. Olympia, Frank Zane.
Number one, I will win. And we'll come on strong, stay long, talk loud, and win the Olympia crowds.
Oh, really?
That's it. Say it, believe it, and achieve it. It's as simple as that. Schwarzenegger goes today. Evita Zane, Evita Schwarzenegger. Samir's coming on strong.
All right, right on.
The Lebanese man.
Lebanese lover.
Oh. How you doing, Kenny?
Good.
Good. Kenny Beard, my manager. You're responsible
feeling
for
everything. Good? Feeling good?
Signs the checks. Keeps you rolling.
You have the pen. The pen is mightier than a muscle in this particular case, right?
That's the gold pen.
Remember the golden rule. He who has the gold makes the rules.
Zane and Arnold in big trouble today.
Oh, I know that.
That's goddamn close.
Yeah.
Close.
Yeah.
So just, you know, remember that.
Right. Oh, yeah, I will.
You remember that.
This damn thing is so close out there. They got so many great bodies in there. You know?
Yeah.
And I've never seen so many guys coming in shape in one contest.
That's right. Yeah, it's a dangerous situation.
That's right.
Yeah, I picked the right year, didn't I?
Check it out, Tommy. Excellent.
A little bit too light, maybe.
Nah. You look great.
It's never been that ripped.
Lighting out there, nothing exists. That's another story.
Good. Brutal. Massive. Brutal. That's it.
You look much better than ever, by far.
He looks better than ever.
Ripped.
Which is enough.
Oh, man.
Yeah, how can he look more than better than ever?
That's pretty hard to do. Maybe next year better than ever.
Yeah. See? But this is next year.
Yeah. You've been reading some philosophy too, I see. I've been doing that every night now, reading philosophy.
Which is good.
It's interesting. It keeps my mind clear.
Fantastic. Confused.
Lost.
What do I do now? How long do you think it will be till we get up there?
Another hour.
About an hour to go.
I mean, for now?
Yeah.
Vielleicht spreche ich von eins, zwei, drei, oder vierte.
Hier?
Eins? Ja, und dann den anderen mit den neuen Armen vorne.
Sechs.
Ja, das spreche ich, glaube ich. Und du?
I would relax if I were you.
Anybody find out
how much more time it is?
We have exactly 20 minutes, okay?
To go out there?
Yeah.
Good.
You can actually create a vision of what your body will look like. And then you mold your body closer and closer to that vision. And actually, you will turn this vision into reality. And it's wonderful, really, to see that happening, that you actually can see it in front of you, which I think they call the third eye, you know, where you visualize what you want to be in reality, and then you get closer and closer to that. And that's a known thing now in sports, the inner sports, they call it.
How are you
today,
sir?
Good face. No, it's home. Perfect. Also, I think just the experience of being much stronger than everybody else, I think that's an unbelievable experience. You feel richer. You feel that sooner or later that you can do anything.
where it is.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Is this yours?
Shape my life. What can I say? I feel great. You know what I mean?
That's good.
And when you know you put your total being, every bit of inner person into your training and into this day, you feel good no matter what. I feel good in that sense. Placing, I don't know. You know? All I know is I'm the best I can be right now. And that's it.
We'll see you later.
Okay.
It's perfect, the oil on the gun side. Everything's perfect.
Yeah, perfect.
Okay? Oh, the underside, he knows.
No, nothing.
Look at the long face. It looks empty there. You know, skin there.
Yeah.
Okay, Danny
Capella.
Everybody likes to be wanted and needed and appreciated and loved and all those things. Some people only have it in a limited way, you know, by just being loved by their family or by their children or by their brother or whatever, a wife. Some people like more than that, you know. Now, I'm one of them. To me, it's always a great pleasure performing in front of a great audience. It really turns me on. And it's a real enjoyable thing, you know, when you see people enjoying what you do.
Okay, Arnold.